Dear students, welcome to Karnataka Learning Management System. Myself, Suguna, Assistant Professor, working at Government First Aid College, NPG Center, Chintamani, Chikkaballapur District. In this video, we are going to solve few problems on volume of revolution. First one, find the volume of the solid generated by revolving the ellipse x square by 16 plus y square by 9 is equal to 1 about x axis. Problem 2. Find the volume of the solid generated by one arc of the cycloid x is equal to a into theta minus sine theta, y is equal to a into 1 minus cos theta about its base. And another problem, show that the volume generated by revolving the curve r square is equal to a square cos theta about the initial line is 8 by 15 phi a square. First problem, we will work out problem 1. Find the volume of the solid generated by revolving the ellipse x square by 16 plus y square by 9 is equal to 1 about the x axis. Given curve is x square by 4 square plus y square by 3 square is equal to 1. X square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1 is the standard equation of the ellipse. So a is equal to 4 and b is equal to 3. Let us draw the diagram of the ellipse. See in this diagram, so a is equal to 4 units and b is equal to 3 units. Now let us take the given curve and equate that to y. So y square is equal to 3 square into 1 minus x square by 4 square we get. Take the equation x square by 4 square plus y square by 3 square is equal to 1 and equate that to y square. The required volume V will be 2 times the volume formed by the revolution of the curve in the first quadrant above the x axis. Now in the diagram, see it is very clear that the total volume will be equal to 2 times the volume found by the revolution of the curve in the first quadrant. So V is equal to 2 integral 0 to A. We are evaluating along the x axis. So x varies from 0 to A. Phi y square dx. This is the standard formula for finding volume. Twice integral 0 to A. Phi y square dx is equal to 2 phi integral 0 to 4 3 square into 1 minus x square by 4 square. That is nothing but y square. So we have substituted y square value in this one. Now by simplifying this, we get V is equal to 18 phi integral 0 to 4 1 minus x square by 4 square dx. Now we can integrate the function 1 minus x square by 4 square. Integral of 1 is x and integral of x square by 4 square is x cube by 3 into 1 by 16. The limits of integration are 0 to 4. So lower limit not necessary to apply. Only upper limit if we apply and simplify. So that is 18 phi into x value is 4. 4 minus 4 by 3. So we get V is equal to 48 phi cubic units. So the volume of the solid found by the revolution of the ellipse is equal to 48 phi cubic units. Next problem. Find the volume of the solid generated by revolving one arc of the cycloid x is equal to a into theta minus sine theta, y is equal to a into 1 minus cos theta about its base. So here the given curves are x is equal to a into theta minus sine theta and y is equal to a into 1 minus cos theta. The baseline is here x axis. Baseline means it is nothing but the initial axis. Now let me draw the diagram. See the cycloid x is equal to a into theta minus theta and y is equal to a into 1 minus cos theta represents this curve. Theta is varying from 0 to 2 phi and here theta value is 5 and along with the curve it is varying as 0 to 5A to 5A. Now see in this diagram, the half of the arc, if you consider, theta is varying from 0 to 5. When you take the revolution of the curve around the base, means around the initial axis, we get the volume as V is equal to twice the integral 0 to A5, 5y square dx. Because when half of the curve is rotated, a solid is formed, and twice of that will give you the complete solid formed. So the volume generated by revolving the curve is V is equal to 2 into integral 0 to A5, 5y square dx. Now let us substitute the values from the given equation. That is, x is equal to A into theta minus sine theta. So when you differentiate this, we get dx by d theta is equal to A into 1 minus cos theta. When x is equal to 0, which implies that theta is equal to 0. See, when x is equal to 0, A into theta minus sine theta will be equal to 0, which implies theta is equal to 0. And when x is equal to 5A, which implies theta is equal to 5. Therefore, the limits of integration are 0 to 5. Hence, V will be equal to twice integral 0 to 5, 5y square dx. Dx is written as dx by d theta into d theta. Consider this as equation 1. Therefore, the equation 1 becomes 2, 5 integral 0 to 5, y square value from the given equation, it is A into 1 minus cos theta whole square. So we have taken as it is this one into dx. Dx value is A into 1 minus cos theta into d theta that we have substituted here. Now simplifying this, we get V is equal to 2 phi A cube integral 0 to 5 1 minus cos theta whole square into 1 minus cos theta. We took it as 1 minus cos theta whole cube. Now convert this 1 minus cos theta into half angle. So we get it as 2 sin square theta by 2 whole cube. Now by simplifying this, we get V is equal to 2 phi A cube integral 0 to 5 8 sin to the power of 6 theta by 2 d theta. So V is equal to 2 phi A cube integral 0 to 5 8 sin to the power of 6 theta by 2 d theta is equal to 16 phi A cube integral 0 to 5 sin to the power of 6 theta by 2 d theta. Now put theta by 2 is equal to 5 so that d theta will be equal to 2 d phi. And when theta is equal to 0, phi becomes 0. And when theta is equal to 5, phi becomes 5 by 2. So the limits of integration have been changed from 0 to 5 to 0 to 5 by 2. Hence, the given integral is V is equal to 16 phi A cube integral 0 to 5 by 2 sine to the power of 6 phi 2 d phi. Now, by using the reduction formula for integral 0 to 5 by 2 sine to the power of nx dx, which is equal to n minus 1 into n minus 3 into so on by n into n minus 2 so on into k, where n is equal to 6. Since n is equal to 6, it is an even number. So we have to multiply that by 5 by 2. Hence, V is equal to 32 phi A cube into 5 by 6 into 3 by 4 into 1 by 2 into 5 by 2. By simplifying this, we get 5 phi square A cube cubic units. This is the required volume of revolution. The next problem. Show that the volume generated by revolving the curve R square is equal to A square cos theta about the initial line is 8 by 15 phi A square. The given curve is R square is equal to A square cos theta. The volume of the solid obtained by revolving the given curve about the initial line at theta is equal to 0, we have to calculate. So for that, let us draw the diagram. See, this diagram represents the R square is equal to A square cos theta. X is varying from 0 to A and theta is 0 here, and here theta is 5 by 2. Now in the first quadrant, theta varies from 0 to 5 by 2. So the total area will be twice of this one. Hence, the volume V is equal to twice integral 0 to 5 by 2, 2 by 3, phi r cube sin theta d theta. It is the formula of finding volume for polar curves. Now let us substitute for r. So we get r square is equal to a square cos theta. So we get V is equal to 4 phi by 3 integral 0 to 5 by 2 a square cos theta whole to the power of 3 by 2 sin theta d theta. Now on simplification, we get this as V is equal to 4 phi a cube by 3 integral 0 to 5 by 2 cos theta to the power of 3 by 2 sin theta d theta. Put cos theta is equal to t, then sin theta d theta is equal to dt. Then the limits of integration also, when theta is equal to 0 implies t is equal to 1, and when theta is equal to 5 by 2 implies t is equal to 0. So the limits of integration from 0 to 5 by 2 we have changed it to 1 to 0. Hence the given integral is V is equal to 4 phi a cube by 3 integral 1 to 0 t to the power of 3 by 2 dt. Now the integral of t to the power of 3 by 2 is t to the power of 5 by 2 by 5 by 2. Limits of integration 1 to 0, we have taken it as 0 to 1 by taking negative sign. So minus 4 phi a cube by 3 into t to the power of 5 by 2 by 5 by 2 limits 0 to 1. So when you apply the upper limit, we get the answer as V is equal to 8 phi a cube by 15 cubic units. Thank you.